Okay, so this is the task one that we'll be taking today. Chart below shows the results of a survey about people's coffee and tea buying and drinking habits in five American cities. All right, so this is according to city, and bought fresh coffee in the last 4 weeks, bought instant coffee in the last 4 weeks, went to a cafe for coffee or tea in the last 4 weeks. Okay. This is your task one.
Yes, sir.
Which one? This one?
Yes, from here.
Okay. The vertical bar graph depicts the outcome of a survey where the buying and drinking habits of Australians regarding coffee and tea are represented. Okay, no problem. So I want to know, why didn't you put the measurements of data here in the introduction? Here.
Yes, sir.
You need to show the measurement of data. So it should be here in the introduction, the measurement of data. The data is calibrated or measured in, let's say, percentage, let's say, dollar or rupees. So the measurement of data should be here, I guess.
I have explained in the next paragraph.
Well, that's okay. I'm just asking about one sentence here for the measurement of the data. Just one line that this data is measured in percentage or whatever it is. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, sir. It
That's
will be
it.
included in the introduction part.
Okay. The overall graph illustrates the percentage of city. Okay. No, very good thing here. See, this line, the first line, the overall graph illustrates in a percentage of city residents.
Yes, sir.
What it illustrates, what it talks about, what the graph is talks about.
Percentage regarding coffee
But it's
and
not talking about
consumption.
the percentage, it's talking about their eating habit. Okay, so it's not just talking about the percentage only. The data is measured in percentage. So this first line should be here. The data is measured in percentage. The overall graph illustrates, or whatever it is, illustrates the habit of people for drinking or for drinking coffee and tea in five different cities of Australia, something like that. Okay, so the first line is only
Okay, sir.
is talking about the percentage of city residents. It should be in the introduction, not
Okay.
here in the overall. The graph shows that most people prefer. Is it in the? There's no year, right? So prefer is okay. No problem. Prefer to go to cafe for coffee or tea in all cities except the one which is Adelaide. Adelaide. Okay. Except the one which is Adelaide. Most people prefer to go to cafe. Okay, so what about these people in Adelaide? They are also preferring to go to cafe.
Not the
Here.
highest percent.
Okay, so let's see how we presented it. You said here the graph shows that most people prefer to go to cafe for coffee or tea in all cities except the one which is Adelaide. Okay, so there in the graph it says it looks like that every single people in every single cities love to go to cafe, right? See, because every single has the data, right? This is what the graph is showing us. But if you go and read this last sentence that you have provided here, it talks about that people who are living in Adelaide do not go to cafe, do not prefer to go to cafe. But they prefer to go to cafe, but not in the, not in like the people living in other cities, but they do go to cafe. And here you're showing here in overall that they don't like to go to cafe for the coffee. And the people who are living in other four cities here, the graph shows that the most people prefer to go to cafe. Most people prefer to go to cafe in all the cities. Okay, except the one which is Adelaide. That means the people who are living in Adelaide, they don't like to go to cafe.
Grammatical error.
Okay, so it's yeah, so what you need to talk about here that okay, so it's not about who prefer to go to cafe or who doesn't prefer to go to cafe. Every single city is showing the data of people living in them, in these cities, and they prefer to go to cafe for the coffee and for the tea. So what they have done here is the people who go to cafe for the fresh coffee are here, okay? So you see a curve here, you see a curve here, if I can, you see a curve here, it was higher, but then it dropped and then it hiked again, right? So there's a curve here. Then if you take a look at people who go for the instant coffee, they go to the cafe, but they go for the instant coffee, right? Not for the fresh coffee. So here is the data for the instant coffee. This one, it increased, dipped a little bit, and then increased again. You see, the first three series are showing the sign of their increment. Okay, and this one went to a cafe for coffee or tea. So these type of people, means here they're not talking about which type of coffee or tea they prefer. What they are showing here is that they go for the coffee or tea only. All right, so but still they are going right to the cafe. So here it was lower, increased, dipped again, increased again. So like what is it, fluctuation, right? It's showing a fluctuation here, but every single people in every single cities are like to go to cafe. Okay, so you need to take a look at the data by carefully what they're asking you to do. Okay, so this one is done. Let me take a look at this one. There are three different categories of residents are given. Why did you give this line here? We don't need this line. Just start comparing, start summarizing the data. Start comparing, start summarizing the data as soon as you jump to para one. This is, there's no requirement of this line. We have already, we need to mention this in the, either in the introduction or in the overview.
Okay, sir.
Okay, we don't, the para one and para two are all about comparing the data. The first category presented fresh coffee bought in a month, and this category showed the least demand among the citizens. Three different categories of residents are given. Categories of the residents are given. The first category presented fresh coffee bought in a month, and this category showed the least demand among the citizens. Where is the data here? The range lied between 34% to 44% only. Okay, why do you have this one in a separate sentence? Why not in this one? Because this sentence doesn't have the data. It needs to have, every single sentence must be comparing and summarizing the data. You can have this type of sentence, but here somewhere in the middle or somewhere here, when you don't have much about the data to explain, right? Okay, so here, on the other hand, why do you have this this phrase here, on the other hand? Why not the other connector? The second category was instant coffee, where the rain light from 46% to 54%, but the third category showed highest consumption. Mean, what is it? Consumption meant about 64% residents prefer to go to cafe for coffee and tea. Okay. We need to talk about your task one. This is not up to the mark. Okay, so let's go and take a look at the first sentence. The first category presented fresh coffee both in a month, and this category showed the least demand among the citizens. If you where it is here, right? So least demanded, right? People very less, not very, but lesser number of people preferred it. In what comparison? In compared to the other two categories.
Yes, sir.
Which are instant coffee and the coffee or tea. So least demanded, but in compared to other two categories. And it is also showing a curve here, right? So if you take a look at very carefully, Brisbane is at the lower level where people prefer fresh coffee less as compared to the other categories, right? You didn't compare it according to the city. You just presented the category. If you take this one, people who were living in Sydney preferred fresh coffee about what is it? About 44% of people living in Sydney preferred fresh coffee, which has a marginal difference compared to those people who prefer instant coffee, right? Okay, then you compare this data. If you want to compare it, you can compare it with this one as well, right?
Yes.
Around 61% people in Sydney, residents of Sydney, prefer coffee or tea, which is almost 33%, it would be around what, how much will that be? 15%? Yeah, so which is 15% higher if it's compared to the other two categories of this one here. That's one case. If you want to compare this one by coffee, not by the cities but by coffees,
okay,
as the data moved from Sydney to Hobart, the preference of people, the preference of fresh coffee by people starts declining, and at Brisbane, around 34% people prefer to drink fresh coffee. And when you go to the Adelaide or Hobart, it show a little bit hike.
No, right? Sir, Adelaide same percentage.
Almost. Okay, you can talk about this one as well. Brisbane and Adelaide are showing the same percentage. The people, citizens who are living in Brisbane or Adelaide, prefer the fresh coffee equally, or whatever the way you want to write it. But at least you are comparing it. You are not just talking about the categories and then you just move on to the second category. No, it doesn't work like that. Compare the data. You can compare the number of people who prefer fresh coffee to the number of people who prefer What? Which one is this one? Instant coffee or the people who prefer coffee or tea? Right? You getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're gonna do the same task one again tomorrow, all right? How's your typing speed on computer?
Not good, sir.
Okay, but it would be better than mine because I am a terrible terrible at typing on computer, seriously. Okay, but this is definitely not up to the mark. You're gonna do this again tomorrow and then we're gonna talk about it again. But did you get my point? What I'm telling you here,
yeah.
Compare the data. Compare.
Okay, so can you please tell me all mistakes which I have made?
Okay, so right now I'm not looking at the grammatical mistakes. I might not be able to find any because you are good, you have a really good command over your English. But what I'm looking at here right now is the comparison. There is a very less comparison. Here, you talk about the first category. Okay, and you just said that it is least demanded among citizens. Then you moved on to the second category here. And you provided the data, no comparison at all. Then you moved on to the third category, you provided the data, no comparison at all. Comparison is far more required than just giving the data. They have given the data here already. They don't want you to just give the data, they want you to compare it.
Okay, sir.
Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So, do you want me to tell you anything on task one, or did you get everything what I want you to do with this one?
What, sir?
Means whatever I told you here, did you get everything here? What you need to do with your introduction, what you need to write on your overall, what you need to write in your para one and para two, and how to compare. Did you get everything?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
In introduction, I should also include the percentage.
Yeah. So introduction is perfectly, this one is perfectly paraphrased. There's nothing wrong with this one. Just add the measurement of unit here. Add the measurement of data here. Right here.
Okay.
Done with that one. Then move on to the overall. So in overview, or let's say overall or in overview. Put the comma and then provide the minimum or maximum of the data, higher or lower of the data, or pick the key data here. Okay, pick the key data here in overview, and so that whoever is reading your overview get the clear picture of the data without even looking at the data. That's my point. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
All right, okay. Okay, so, okay. One more thing I want to tell you here about the overview. What you can do is that, let's say we are providing the data in the overview. Actually, we don't give the data in the overview, but we need to provide the overall picture of the data in the overview without giving the data, okay? Okay?
Yes.
So, right, so what I'm going to do here,
your voice is not coming, sir.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
All right, okay. Because I was thinking, that's why my voice wasn't coming. Sorry about that. Okay. All right, so what we are looking at here is that if we want to provide the overall picture here, we can see people who prefer fresh coffee show the curve, okay, or the data of the people preferring instant coffee, fresh coffee shows the curve here, and the most striking feature is that data or the percentage of people preferring coffee or tea shows the fluctuation. Shows the fluctuation here, right? If you want to put it this way, people preferring fresh coffee shows a curvy trend amongst all the cities. Curvy trend, and the most striking feature is that people who are preferring coffee or tea are in the fluctuation or showing the fluctuation, or the way we want to put it, you can say that this data shows a downward trend and an upward trend can be seen in this data, but none of the data is showing the complete downward and complete upward trend. Okay, this data, if you take a look at this one here in St. Kofi, it shows an upward trend in the starting, then with the very minor fluctuation, with minor dip, with minor dip, it jumped again a little. Okay, so a margin, it showed a margin dip.
Your voice is not coming, sir.
Now, is it coming now?
Hello.
Hello, you there? Let me see. So you get the idea of how to put it. You can compare, you can give one or two data, a key data key in the overview, then one data you can save for the striking feature. So if you come here, provide just one data, this is higher, this is lower, or this data is showing the upward trend, this data is showing the minor, the downward trend. The most striking feature is then the key data here, without giving the data, okay? Then it will be a complete overall.
Okay, sir.
That the picture?
Here I discuss about the three main categories, but what is depicting it?
Yeah, whatever whatever you are looking at in the data, pick an upward data with the upward trend, pick the another data with the downward trend, and then keep one data for the striking feature. So you talk about three key points from the graph in your overall, right?
Okay.
But if you are given two graphs with the data, then you don't need to increase the number of sentences, just write the two sentences only, okay? Upward trend, downward trend, and then the key feature. Okay. Get the point?
Yes, sir.
All right, okay. So you're gonna do it tomorrow again, and then we're gonna talk about it tomorrow again, right? And let's see the progress here, all right? And even if you make again the mistakes in the comparing the data, don't worry about it. You will learn by making mistakes, all right?
Right, sir.
Okay, so thank you so much for joining for this task one.